and separation at the bottom of the deck. So I see that you might be in a separation with someone, and the separation has happened because you both have very different views and belief systems. Maybe you're from different culture, community, background. Maybe parents are causing an issue in your connection. So it's not the problems between you and them, but it's more of that external influence is affecting this relationship. Maybe you are very spiritual, they are not. Maybe you're very religious, they are not. So something about your belief system that you have developed while growing up, or the views or the opinions that you have in life, is becoming an obstruction in this connection with this person. And you are in separation with this person right now, currently as we speak. You definitely have a lot of attraction for them and vice versa, but the red flags have become so dominant that you guys are in separation, okay? And it's not working with them. Let's see what the tarot has to say. Give me a message for Cancer, please. For love, for 10, 11 to the 30 of November. 10 of Cups, 8 of Pentacles, and the King of Wands. Sorry, the Knight of Wands. Yeah, I mean, I don't sense that you guys don't like each other or something like that. That's not the case here. It's just that it's the outer influence somehow, which is causing you guys to be in a separation right now, okay? This person wants to have a new beginning with you, and I think it's not even about new beginning. It's like you had a full-fledged connection, you had stability with them, but because of the external influence or whatever it is that you are going through right now is causing a separation. But internally, like internally, you want to be with this person, you want to fix this connection with them, you want to work on your differences, okay? There's a lot of passion, as I said. There's a lot of passion and attraction. You both are very much magnetically attracted to each other. There is something that holds you together, no matter physically you are together or not. You have each other on your mind, okay? And I think you also keep tabs on each other. So you might be stalking them and they might be doing that as well. But there is this influence, the external influence, which is causing you guys to be separate. So what next is going to happen in this connection? Five of Pentacles and the Eight of Wands. You definitely yearn for this communication from this person, and the communication might come as well. I see this person might reach out to you, but you know, in like now you've reached a point where it's very difficult for you to take this forward, right? So you feel the damage has been done and a lot has been disturbed in the connection, and no amount of passion can resolve it. So you know, even though this person might come in and show in a lot of passion to you, but you'll be like, nah, but we are, you know, so separated and things have become so difficult, I don't think it can work, and etc. So that can be the case, that you feel that the damage has been done, sort of thing, right? You feel that this person did not take your stand when you wanted them to do it for you. Maybe when you were going through this separation and when things were falling apart, they did not take your stand, and now you feel rejected, you feel abandoned, okay? And you think that you cannot trust this person, though they have a lot of passion for you and they want to make it work, but you can't trust, okay? You think that they did not acted courageously, maybe they did not show courage during that time, and now you can't trust. So what is the intention of this person towards my Cancer next? Queen of Wands, they keep you at the pedestal. I mean, you think that this has gone for a toss and nothing can sort out, but this person sees you in a very good light, and they think really highly of you. Four of Pentacles, they want stability with you, they don't want things to scatter or fall apart. Like, they want that you guys should work on your differences and sort it out. Knight of Swords. This person is coming in really quickly to fix it with you because they somehow want to save this connection, or if you're married, then they want to save the family. But you can't trust them now, because when it was the chance for them to do it, they did not do it, and now you'll be like, I'm not sure. Temperance and Judgment. Some of you are being asked to rethink the situation. Don't shoo this person away, okay? If you also love this person somehow, then you have to work on it. Right now, you're very caught up in the situation. You feel very suffocated and caged. Okay, like this is the problem with this connection, that you can't move forward and you can't stay back. So you're being asked to take some time and not take an action in a hurry, because I see that you also have feelings for them, but you feel cheated. So you can't trust, basically. The problem is that you can't trust this person now, but you have feelings, right? You want this to work, but you can't trust, okay? So you are being asked to work on this situation and find the middle ground. With the Three of Cups, I think, I know things are difficult, but obviously love is difficult, right? Connections are difficult. You have to work for them. Eight of Cups. But no matter how much I would say, I think you've made your mind that you want to walk away from this person, or you think that you can't put up with them. So that's your wish. Any advice for Cancer, please? Right now, you just don't want to think about them. You'll be like, nah, yeah. I think you think this person had a lot of secrets as well. Maybe they were just hiding a lot from you, and then you got to know about it, and then you were like, I can't deal with this anymore. So right now you feel cheated, you feel betrayed, you feel there was a lot kept from you. This person was not honest about their feelings with you, and you feel defeated, okay, in this situation. Yeah, Ten of Swords. You feel defeated, you feel that you can't make it work with them. Alright, so what's coming in for my single Cancerians in love next? This is for people who are dealing with someone and trying to make a situation work. But let's see for my singles, please. What is coming toward my single Cancerians? So you have a Gemini or a soulmate connection coming towards you. Two of Cups. Wow. For singles, I see definitely scope of love. Could be a water sign or a Gemini coming in towards you. They have a lot of love for you, and they want to make it work with you as well. So this is a very strong connection coming in your way. But for some of you, I think you are trying to stay away. As I said, you know, you're very adamant of at not giving a chance to anybody. You think you're single and you're fine, and you don't want to get involved in heartbreaks and etc. So that's why you don't want to even invest. So some of you need to stop this attitude if you want love in life. Like you can't block everybody and then expect communication, right? That's stupid. So I think you have love for singles, especially. I see that you have love, but you're not giving into the situation. You don't want to deal with people. You think you're done with them. So Four of Swords. Yeah, you just don't want to deal. I think you don't want to deal with people because you think whatever heartbreak you've had, it's too much for you and you can't take it. And you just are trying to focus on your career. You're just trying to focus on your stability. But there is someone who wants to have a reconciliation with you. There is someone who wants to work it out with you again. But you'll be like, wait a minute, let me first sort my life. I can't trust you. You know, you are in that sort of energy right now. Yeah, you think that this is an unrequited love. So you have lost love for this person, but they have it for you still. Okay, so that's that. Let's see from Aries to Pisces for Cancer, please. Give me messages for Aries. So the Aries want a forward movement with you, and they want to work the situation with you. Aries is head over heels for you, and it's a very stable connection with Aries though. They want to take responsibility in this connection. They want to make it work, sort of. All right, Taurus. Taurus is looking to tame the situation with you. They want to work it out with you. They think that in the distant future, you can really have something solid, and they want to work on the foundation right now. They think you can end up together. Gemini. The Gemini is holding back, or you are holding back from a Gemini. You think it's a lot of hard work with them, but they want to have a new beginning with you. Someone is holding back. Yeah, so I think one of you is holding back and the other person wants love. So someone has love and the other person is holding back. Cancer. Ooh, Cancer wants to settle down with you. They want to settle down with you. They want to make you public. Like, they want to show to people that you guys are dating and etc. But you are not honest about your feelings to them, or vice versa. Like, one person is not honest about their feelings to the other person, but there is love here. Leo. Leo wants to have clear communication with you. They'll be telling you things as they are. Some of you just had this sudden breakup with the Leo and you can't trust. Yeah, I mean, even if this person comes back to you, you can't trust. And you're also feeling very anxious about this connection with the Leo. Virgo. You think Virgo is hiding a lot from you, and Virgo also abandoned you when you wanted them the most. You're trying to focus on your money right now. You don't want to deal with this person. Libra. The Libra is very defensive. They don't tell you what it is. And you want to have a reconciliation with them. But this person is very defensive. I think a lot of drama has happened between both of you. So I think they are trying to turn their back and move on. But you want a reconciliation. Scorpio is reaching out with communication, a message or an apology. They want to fix it with you. Yeah, they have passion. Sagittarius is second guessing this connection. They want stability with you. That's why they are taking time. So when they come back, it's not going to be mumbo jumbo, you know. All right, 10. Capricorn is going to reach out to you, but it could be a little slow. I think you are in a karmic situation or a soulmate situation with the Capricorn. They really like you for the stability that you offer, and they want to make it work with you. You might be wanting a fast movement, but this person is taking their time. So you guys are not on the same page. Aquarius. Ooh, there could be an apology or a message coming in from an Aquarius. I think somebody did nasty to someone and they got it back, and they realize and they want to heal this connection. Okay, so they want to equal it with you, basically. It's all about stability here. Yeah. Pisces. Oops. Ooh. The Pisces wants to make it work with you, and they will. I see a reconciliation with the Pisces. I think somebody left somebody in the cold, and somebody is also blocked right now. You or them or both of you. But yeah, they want to make it work with you. Like, they choose you sort of situation. So yeah, that was the reading. Hope this helps and resonates. If it does, subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next. You guys take care. Bye.